Hey guys, welcome back. So hello, my name is Sarah. If you're new, hello. And I'm so glad you're here. I make a ton of plus size fashion videos. I also make a bunch of different other lifestyle content, including what's for dinner videos, cook with me videos, clean with me videos, decorate with me videos, beauty and makeup and mom videos, lifestyle content, all of that stuff. So if any of that strikes your fancy, I would love it if you subscribed and joined our channel. And on that note, we have hit 10,000 subscribers. I think now we're at like 10,100 and something. And I'm so excited and thankful for you guys. I know in the grand scheme of things, 10,000 is so little, but that's 10,000 people. That's insane to me. It's crazy. It's so easy to get distracted by numbers and look at big YouTubers and be like, oh, they got millions or hundreds of thousands or whatever. And it's like, they're 10,000. It's huge. It's a huge number of people. And I am so thankful for each and every one of you to help me reach this goal and this dream of mine. I started my channel when I was kind of in a funk and was going through some postpartum depression and anxiety after I had my second daughter, and I just kind of lost who I was in that. And not that I don't love being a mom or that I don't love being a wife, because those are two of my absolute favorite things in the whole entire world, but it just really kind of consumed me, and I really wanted a place that I could still be me and find myself again and learn more about myself in these different roles and be creative and just engage in a community. And you guys allowed me to do that. I would never in my wildest dreams imagine that 10,000 of you would want to watch my channel, so thank you. And also on that note, the giveaway that I had on my last try-on haul, which was the Rose Gal try-on haul, I was giving away two different pairs of Astra Signature shorts, and I picked the winners. I just messaged them on Instagram, so check your DMs. But I entered their, just entered all of the comments in a randomizer thing on YouTube, or on Google, you can just like Google it. And the two winners for the shorts, because I have a pair of XL and 2X, and the first one is Cheryl Cliproton for the XL shorts, so check your Instagram DM because I just sent you one, and Brandy McCarty who won the 2X size. So thank you guys so much for subscribing and entering, and thank you for supporting me. I'm so thankful. So if either of those were you, please enter or please check your DMs so I can send them out to you as soon as possible. Okay, moving on. So today's try-on haul is a pretty old good size one. A lot of you guys wanted me to do another Forever 21 haul. My last Forever 21 haul was inside the dressing room, so this time I decided to place an order online just because I did not have the best experience, honestly, when I actually went to the Forever 21 store. I definitely feel like it is so much better to order online because you just have pretty much all the sizes you'd want. It's so accessible. There's so many good things about it. But and they've been having bomb sales. I feel like for a while their prices were just astronomical, and I was like, there's no way I'm spending $45 on this like dress. It's gonna fall apart in three washes. But then they just started having so many good sales, and I love Forever 21's like fall winter stuff. So I placed an order, and I am so happy with everything, guys. I am so excited to share this stuff with you because I got some good ones. All right, originally the price was $98, which for six items to me is pretty good. Normally I would spend way more than that, I feel like, at the store. And then they had a sale going on, and I got like $20 off, so basically it came down to $65.15 and shipping was free. So totally lucked out on this. I feel like everything I got I really liked. I also want to throw in a couple items from Amazon because I don't have enough to make a haul and a full video on it, and you guys love Amazon too. So let's just get started. Okay, so the first thing I am showing you is a bodycon dress. And honestly, I was pretty nervous to get this because sometimes when it comes to bodycon dresses, the fabric is really thin and it shows everything. Even when you have shapewear on, I just didn't want to be like a really stuffed, taut, taut, a really stuffed, like, tight sausage that's, like, wanting to burst out at the seams. So I was kind of nervous, but this had really good reviews and the pricing was really great, so I decided to take the plunge. The reason that I picked this dress is, I'll enter the picture if I can find it. I follow her here on YouTube, she's amazing, and on Instagram. And why is her name blanking for me? I also have it on here. She's amazing and great. You should definitely follow her. But she had this, I think I found this on Pinterest, and I loved the idea of this outfit. I thought it was so cute, and so I needed to recreate it. So I found this black bodycon dress, and honestly, when I ordered it, I thought it was gonna be like really cheap, not cheap, really thin, like jersey cottony material, and this is like super thick. Like, I was so incredibly surprised when I got this. And I will also say, this stuff is like, I was also nervous that it wouldn't fit, let's just be honest. Like, it's definitely stretchy, but on first initial like looking and just trying to put it on my body, I was like, this ain't gonna work. And then went it on, and oh my gosh, guys, if you get anything from this haul, let it be this. This is so good. My butt looks great in this, and it like smooths everything out. My tummy looks good, my boobs look good. Like, this is the dress that you need in your life. Anyway, this is originally $14.99. I'm gonna tell you the price that I paid for all of, or the price that are on the tags, just because, you know, sales are different and everything, but I think they're running a sale right now anyway. But this is $14.99, and this is so worth it. I will try to make sure I have everything linked below. I did get this in a 2X, and I will say that everything I think I pretty much sized up on, because I read all of the reviews, and I've noticed that a lot of Forever 21's clothes have begun to run a lot smaller. I feel like they used to run a bit larger, and now they've like changed. And so, like, if you go on the Forever 21 website and you look at an item, they'll have like a little dial thing at the bottom where the reviews, and we'll say like run small, run bigs, runs like true to size. And like 90% of the stuff that I bought had, was the dial was all the way to the edge, so I knew it ran definitely small. So I did size up to a 2X. I'm a pretty true 1X if you've been watching me for a while, pretty true 16, and I'm definitely glad I sized up. So that's what I would say, I would definitely size up. But guys, even with that, you need this dress. I feel like this is gonna look so cute with cardigans, with flannels, which is the look that I want to go for, with freaking, I like, you can dress this up and be fancy. I love this thing. Highly recommend it. For $14.99, you can't beat it. All right, this next item I had to get because I've mentioned it a million times, and you guys are probably so tired of me talking about it, but of watching Sabrina, Chilling Adventures of Sabrina Spellman. This totally gave me Sabrina vibes amongst just any other like cute mini skirt fall vibes. And it's this corduroy like deep crimson burgundy mini skirt. Now it has like buttons on all the way down, and these are all usable. You can like button yourself out of it. And I believe it has pockets. Am I just imagining that? Yeah, I guess I am. It doesn't have pockets, but for whatever reason, I thought it had like little front pockets. But once again, I also sized up to a 2X on this one. This one was another thing that said run small. However, I feel like of all of the item, well, this item, I feel like I could have probably got a 1X in. I'm glad I got a 2X in, but I could have sized down and it would have been fine. I just like things to fit looser. If you've been watching me for a while, you guys know that. I don't like tight items, but this does have a little bit of stretch and a little give in it. However, super cute. I think this is so adorable. This totally gives me Sabrina vibes. I think with like a black turtleneck and some black tights, I will totally just do that with some black booties. Or like I have a bodysuit I'm about to show you with it, or like a mustard top. Oh, so many cute things. And this was $22.90. Once again, I got everything on sale, but this is the, like, you know, normal price. Anyway, but I really like it. I think it's really cute, super fun for fall, and I think it transitions well to the holidays. Okay, so speaking of that bodysuit, I decided to get a bodysuit. I think in the whole history of my life, besides when I was a child, I have purchased one bodysuit, and I showed you guys that one not too long ago. I got it from Amazon and I loved it. So I decided to go on another leap and get another one, and I'm really happy with this. So once again, I sized up. I'm pretty sure I sized up in everything just to be on the safe side. Forever 21 is a junior plus store, so things run in junior sizing. It's not women's or misses or anything like that, so things typically cut smaller and shorter and all of that stuff, so just keep that in mind. And this is just a white ribbed bodysuit. It's like really basic. It just looks like a white t-shirt, but it goes and snaps at the lady bits, and it's a V-neck. They have this in black, and I would really like to get it in black as well. I ordered the white, just not being totally sure. And I kind of wish that I got it in black. I don't know really what made me like, oh yeah, get the white. I don't know what made me do that, but I kind of wish I got the black. However, I still plan on getting it. This was $12.90, which I think is definitely a nice price for it. Like I said, I did get this in the 2X, and I believe on the website, this also was another thing that said it ran small. Pretty much, I would say everything ran small. But I like it a lot, you know? I like it a lot. I honestly don't know if I'm going to buckle these. Just because I think this lays really well and tucked in, it doesn't like come out. And since these are longer, it helps. Like, I don't know if I'm gonna button these because I just feel like weird doing that. I don't know. I just feel like a little baby, but not a little onesie. So I may just tuck it in, but it works totally fine with that. Once again, $12.90. I think this is really nice. I definitely would size up. This next item I'm super disappointed in. This was the one thing that did not work for me and did not fit, and I'm kind of frustrated about it. So I wanted to get one of those like super trendy double loop belts. I don't have a lot of belts, and I just like, I think these add just like an extra touch of, you know, something. And I went on the plus size section to the belt section and everything. I double checked this like 3 times, and it said that this was in the plus size or plus size area. It didn't say plus size like on the actual like clicking thing. Why can I not think the link? But none of the other belts said plus size on them either. So I was like, okay, these just, they're still in there. Like, they wouldn't put regular size, like straight size belts with a plus size category, or so I thought. I got the medium large thinking like, let's hope. And everything said that this ran big. Guys, this doesn't fit my waist, okay? And I'm not talking like my hips, I got wide hips, but like this doesn't fit like the smallest part of my waist. So definitely wouldn't recommend this. And I'm a little perturbed that they had this like in that section when it's not plus size. So just keep that in mind. This was really cute, I'm gonna have to take it back. It was $7.99, it wasn't super expensive, but I'm just letting you know. A little annoyed with that one. So this next freaking thing. Oh my gosh, I already think I found out what I'm wearing for Christmas. This is stunning. I've seen this a couple of times and just never got it because I didn't want to spend the money and yada, yada, yada. But I did this time, and guys, so good. And basically it is this, oh, this is not going to do it justice at all. Basically it is just this like, I can't even hold it up. Crisscross tied jumpsuit. And it's in this beautiful like eggplant purple color. They also had it in black, and it's velvet, and it is stunning. I already have a black jumpsuit, otherwise I would have gotten it in black. But I just thought this was just a different color, and it is so flattering, so beautiful. I did once again size up in this one. However, this item does run big. I think that it ran like a tiny bit small. It wasn't like all the way at the end, or might have been true to size, but I just sized up because I typically always size up in jumpsuits because I like it to be flowy, and I find jumpsuits typically run smaller anyway. However, I will say I feel like this definitely runs a bit true to size. I really like it. I think it's beautiful. It's nice and stretchy. I love the way it flows on my legs and my tummy. It's just super like gappy in the boobs area, so I'm gonna have to like use tape to kind of tape that down, but totally worth it. Definitely, definitely recommend. The only thing I will say is it does pick up a lot of lint really easily. I mean, that's like the nature of like faux velvet, but still, I think this is so beautiful for the holidays. If you're going to do something fancy for Thanksgiving, this is beautiful. Like, I think this will be great for Christmas and New Year's. Like, so stunning. This was $34.90 and totally worth it. It's a nice weighty piece. Like, this is a nice quality item. Go Forever 21. All right, so moving on to the last thing I got at Forever 21. And this was also inspired by another Instagrammer, and I will leave her Instagram picture thing that I got inspired by. She's stunning. I follow her all the time as well, and she had this outfit, and I just saw it, and I was like, I need it. I need that. I need to look like that. I need that outfit. So I saw that she linked at Forever 21, so I went on a hunt. I found this skirt, and it's just this black denim mini skirt. It's frayed at the bottom, and the sides have zippers. So, I mean, you can literally zip yourself out of them. But super just cool. I love the like wash of it, because it's not like super dark black. It's kind of like acidy wash and faded and light. Now I can't get this back down. Go me. There we go. And I just thought it was really cute and fun. Once again, sized up in this one to a 2X, because it did say it ran really small. And honestly, I feel like I should have sized up to a 3X. I feel like the waist would have been too big. My husband even said the waist looks kind of gappy on as you already, but it's really tight in the hips. So like, it's a little bit gappy on the waist, but the hips, it's definitely really snug, and it's really short. I wore it with the black pantyhose. I wore it to my friend's birthday dinner party, and I loved the way it looked, but it definitely is not like a super comfortable item. Like, I don't feel, but then again, I'm always in leggings. So, I mean, to each their own. I recommend it. Still, I think it's really cute, but I absolutely recommend sizing up. And if you are super hippie like I am, maybe an extra size up, two sizes up. I just don't know if it'd have been too gappy the waist in. That's my only issue. I believe this was under $20. I did take the tag off of this one, but originally I do believe it was under $20. I think it's really cute. I love the detailing of the zipper. And to go with it, I could not find a black denim jacket that matched that one on Forever 21. The one she has is cropped, and I really wanted a cropped one like it, but once again, I was out of luck. So I went on Amazon, my favorite place in the whole entire world, and I found this one. Now, this one is not cropped, and it's definitely oversized. I think I got an extra large, yes, and it's still pretty big. So if you can size down even more than that, I would recommend it. Like, I definitely would recommend sizing down one to two sizes, because it is very oversized. However, if you're going for that look, I think it's perfect for it. But it's just this really cute, once again, same kind of faded denim. I cuffed the sleeves, and I just think this is so cute. I love these types of jackets. I love just feeling like my old, like, 90s grunge. It's totally my vibe, and I just wanted to make this outfit work. So I will have at least my original outfit kind of together and a try on haul, so you can kind of see where I was going for it. It was just kind of like a two-piece fun denim black grungy moment. I lived for it. I loved it. And I really like this jacket. They also have it in a bunch of different colors. I will have a link on Amazon. I think this is a really nice price for this. It's a nice well-made jacket. I will say on both of the items, I don't know if it's the dye smell or what, but it is very strongly like dye scented. It smells chemically, so I really need to just like do an even deeper wash, because it's a strong scent. But I still think it's really cute. I love the ruggedness, the grunginess of it. Amazon kills it. As always, this had really good reviews, and they have different versions. I think they do have some cropped ones. They have some white ones and all sorts of stuff, so I have it linked below as well. But like I said, I got this as an extra large, and I definitely think that you need to size down one to two sizes. These next two items are like dressier items. I do get a lot of comments from you guys asking for me to do more like dressy, like cocktail attire items and stuff like that. The only issue is like stuff like that is super expensive, and I just don't have a need for them. So I do try to include certain items like that when I do have to go shopping or whatnot for them, so you guys can have some ideas and examples. But normally it's just so expensive that I don't get the opportunity to really show those to you. But I will show you these two items that I did get. I went to a wedding recently. It was beautiful and wonderful, and I didn't wear either of these items to it, but I would have. This first dress is show-stopping to me. I think it is a stunning dress. I think this is amazing for weddings coming up. I think this is amazing for the holiday parties, New Year's Eve. Like, this is just hot date. Like, this is so beautiful. And it is like an off the shoulder black little slinky number. It's kind of has like a cape almost to it. I am obsessed with capes. I don't know what. I mean, it's this time of year. Plus, like, watching, I've just watched a bunch of Harry Potter recently. I was watching Sabrina, like, just in the witchy mood. So when I was shopping for this wedding, I literally picked out so many things that had capes. but I just think that it adds so much drama to it. It's a little bit different and unique, but it's a very, like, elegant silhouette. I will say that I feel like the fit on me isn't 100% perfect. But I feel like if I size down, it would show more than I would like. Like, I feel like it wouldn't be as figure flattering. But if I, it's just, it has like a little excess fabric in like the tummy area and the butt area. It's not as like skin tight. I don't know why I slept. Skin tight as I would have wanted it. But then again, if I had it that tight, I may not have liked it on me. I personally would wear this with like Spanx and stuff underneath it. But if you aren't somebody who likes to wear shapewear or doesn't have shapewear, you do you. I still feel like it would look beautiful without it. But I just personally would wear it just because that's who I am. That's what I like. But they did have this in a bunch of other colors, and all the reviews were really good. This is like a really thick, stretchy material. It is completely opaque, at least the black color. You can wear what you want to wear underneath it, you know what I'm saying? And it's just beautiful. I don't know what else to say besides that I think this is an amazing dress. If you have a cocktail party coming up, a wedding, holiday, company parties typically are a little bit fancier, New Year's, all of those things. I feel like this will work for so many events, and it's so beautiful. So, and really, really simple. And inexpensive. I believe this was under $30. I will have everything linked again, like I said. And this last item, I wanted to get last year, and I didn't have a reason for it. And then I've seen it advertised all over this year, this exact one and similar ones like it. And I decided to bite the bullet and get it. Now, my husband thought this was incredibly conservative, which is not a bad thing, but he just thought it looked more funeral appropriate than like black tie wedding appropriate. So this video was pre-filmed, and I actually was in about 20 minutes during this video. I was about to receive a call that my dad had collapsed and was passing away. And ironically, when I mentioned that my husband said that it was a funeral dress, I ended up actually wearing it to my dad's funeral. It was beautiful. I actually got a lot of compliments, which is kind of weird, all things considering, but I loved it and I would recommend it. I think it is a beautiful dress for many occasions, but I just want to let you know that this video is pre-filmed. Keep that in mind, but I didn't think it looked funerally, but it did have like an Addams Family vibe, but I loved that about it. First off, it's just this black dress, spaghetti strap dress, and what I actually really love is, one, it's like a sweetheart cut, but two, that there's two straps. I just feel like that adds a little extra something. I love it, kind of creates a caging kind of vibe. This is just a very simple black dress. It has a really nice kind of like weight to it and stretch. It seems over your lumps and bumps really well. However, I will say once again, I would wear shapewear with this. Because I like the look of that better on me. But I still think this looks really nice. It is a very classic kind of like 1950s fit, and where it's like cinched in at the waist and kind of like flows out. You can wear a petticoat under this. You don't have to. I feel like these are one of these dresses that sometimes when you order, it's like you need that petticoat to kind of like fluff it up. But this particular item, I feel like looks, on in my opinion, better even without the petticoat. But if you wanted to give it more of that like retro flair, it would totally work with it as well. And then all it comes with on top is this adorable little like capelet cloak, cute friggin' thing, and it's a Peter Pan collar. Probably can't see this at all. It's like a Peter Pan collar, like kind of design, and there's just one little button in the back. Now, I've seen multiple people try this on in hauls where they'll have like the Peter Pan collar type in the back, and they have more of like the traditional kind of darted collar in the front where it kind of opens up in the front where their like chest is. Online it shows to wear the Peter Pan collars in the front and there's no opening. I like that personally better, but you do you. Like, I feel like this is awesome because you can switch it wherever way you want to. This doesn't choke me. Like, I don't feel like it's too tight around my neck. I honestly don't know what size neck I have, like if it's a large neck or not a large neck. I haven't really ever had a problem with wearing necklaces, so I don't know what that means, but I'm just saying, like, it fits my neck just fine and I don't feel like I'm choking or anything like that. Really beautiful, just flowy, and I love it. I think it's beautiful and I think it'd be really fun once again for the holidays as well. I read somebody in the comments, they felt like they were Fleur from Harry Potter, from Goblet of Fire. What is that school called? It's like the women's school. What is that called? I just watched that one. Dang it. You know what I'm talking about if you love Harry Potter and you know what I'm talking about, but they have like blue, beautiful capelet coat things. I don't know. That was just like the vibe that she felt like. And anyway, I love it. I think it's beautiful and it's really fun, like spooky for this time of year. And I think it'd be kind of a cool idea if you want to like witchy it up with like some cool tights and like some like intense makeup and like a big cool pointy witch's hat, maybe some like little dainty like black lace tea gloves. That would look so cute for like a really beautiful like plus size witch's costume. That's a good idea. I recommend that one. Okay, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please check out the links below. I am really, really happy with how all of these items turned out for the most part, besides the freaking belt. But I would love to share them with you. And I know some of you guys have been so happy with the stuff that I've shared before, and I just love sharing with you guys. So let me know again what other places you would like to see. I'm hoping to go out to Torrid pretty soon and doing a big film inside the dressing room there, but I'm trying to hit all the stores as much as I can. So I got Forever 21 checked on my list, so let me know below if you would like to see any other places. And thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, follow me on Instagram at Sarah England. And yeah, I will see you guys all very soon in my next video. Bye guys.